Miles to go, everyone. Welcome to today's session of Social Science Geography, Class 8, Chapter 1, Resource. What is a resource? Resource is anything which is used to satisfy one's need. So that is known as resource. Anything which is used to satisfy one's need is known as resource. Now, resource need to have a utility, then only it can be used for satisfy the need. So what do we mean by utility? That second word is utility. Utility is the usability which makes any object or a substance a resource. The usability or utility of any object or substance makes it a resource. So for example, if I am thirsty, I need a glass of water. So water become a resource. Now why it is a resource? Because the water can satisfy, it can quench my thirst. And that is the reason, that is the utility of water, and that's the reason it is a resource. Am I clear? Things become resource only when they have value. Its use and utility gives it a value. The use or utility of a resource gives it a value. All resources have value. Some resources have economic value, some do not. Value means the worth. How much valuable that is to you. Time and technologies are two important factors that can change any substance into a resource. Both are related with the need of the people. People themselves are important resource. It is their ideas, their inventions, their discoveries which has led to creation of more resources. Like, for example, a fire was discovered. But discovery of fire led to discovery of new recipes of food. Say for example, a wheel was invented. So when wheel was invented, it led to the invention of more or new modes of transport. Resources are divided into three types. They are, first is natural resource, second is human-made or man-made resource. Third is most important, the human resource. Now we'll try to understand about these different three types of resources one by one. To start with, the natural resource. Natural resource is classified into four different groups. The first is, it is based on the basis of the level of development. Second, on the basis of origin. Third, on the basis of stock, and third, on the basis of distribution. We'll try to understand each one of them one by one. The first group is on the basis of the level of development. This is further divided into two, the actual resource and the potential resource. Now, what is actual resource? Actual resource is the resource which we know that in what quantity it is available to us and we are using it at present also. For example, the coal deposit, the other mineral deposit we have. So we know in what quantity it is available to us and we know how to use it and we are using it at present also. The second is potential resource. Now what is potential resource? Potential resource are those resources whose entire quantity is not known to us, but we can use it in future. And other thing is that we do not have the technology or the advanced technology to use that resource right now at present. So we know that
the resource is there, but we will use it in future. So that resource is known as potential resource. Example, like the uranium deposit we have in Ladakh. So we know that it is available, but we don't know in what quantity it is available. And second, we do not have the technology or advanced technology to use that resource.
Now let's talk about the second group, which is on the basis of origin. Now it is further divided into two. One is abiotic and second is biotic. Abiotic resource and biotic resource. Abiotic resource are the resource which are not living or non-living. For example, rocks, soil, coal, all these resources are abiotic resource. The second is biotic resource. So biotic resource is the resource which is living. For example, the animals, the plants, all these resources are biotic resource. Fine. Let's move to the third group, which is on the basis of stock. So what do we mean by stock? Stock means that something which you have in your account or something, you know how much it is available or how much reserves you have. Now, this is broadly divided into two. One is known as renewable resources. The other is known as non-renewable resources. Now, renewable resources are those resources which can be renewed, which can be replenished. For example, like solar energy, wind energy, which is available in abundance and which can be renewed or replenished. Second is non-renewable resources. Non-renewable resources are those resources that are available right now, but it can get exhausted in times to come. Now let's come to the fourth group, which is on the basis of distribution. Now, distribution of natural resources depends on various physical factors like the terrain, the climate, the altitude. Depending on all these physical factors, the resources are different at different places. It is divided into two. One is ubiquitous and one is localized. Ubiquitous and localized resources. What is ubiquitous? Ubiquitous means omnipresent. The resource which is available everywhere and to everyone. So one of these resources is air or the sunlight. Second is localized. Localized resources are the resources which are available at certain places only. For example, the coal deposits, the iron ore deposits, or other mineral deposits or resources, because of the physical factors, they are available at certain places only. Understand man-made resource or human-made resource. Now, sometimes the natural resources or natural substance which is available becomes resource only when the original form of that has been changed. For example, iron ore. When we extract iron ore from the rock, then only it becomes usable, then only it becomes a resource. So we can see that when iron is extracted from the rock, it is transformed into an iron, and then from iron it becomes steel, and then it is used in various things like roads, like bridges, like machineries, like vehicles. So this is known as human-made or man-made resource. Technology is also a human-made resource. Human resource is one of the most important resources available to us. It refers to numbers and abilities. Number of people having abilities, physical and mental abilities. Education and health are two things which make people more valuable resource. Improving the quality of skills so that the people can become a valuable resource and can create more resources is known as human resource development. Understand conserving resources. What do we mean by that? Using resources carefully and give them time to renew is called resource conservation. Now let's understand what is sustainable development. Sustainable development means carefully utilizing resources so that beside meeting the requirement of present, we can also take care of future generation. We use resources in a way that it can be used by the generations to come, is known as sustainable development.